So a very good morning, dear children. Welcome to my channel, Maths with Manti Sir. Children, in the last class, we were discussing about congruent triangles, okay? Where I discussed what is the sufficient condition for two triangles to be congruent. If you recall what we had read earlier, what I had discussed, I had said that two triangles will be congruent if what? Under what condition we will say that two triangles will be congruent if they have same shape and same size. And what is the meaning of size I had discussed? Size means the three pairs of corresponding sides of the two triangles must be equal and the three pairs of corresponding angles of the two triangles must be equal. Then only we say that two triangles are congruent. That means the sufficient condition for two triangles to be congruent are the three pairs of corresponding sides of both the triangles should be equal and the three pairs of corresponding angles of both the triangles should be equal. Now children, if it is the sufficient condition, now just tell me one thing. Is it very easy to test? Is it very easy to always test that the three pairs of corresponding sides of two triangles are equal and the three pairs of corresponding angles of two triangles are equal so that we will claim or decide that two triangles are congruent? It is a very time-taking affair. It will take a lot of time to always verify that the three pairs of corresponding sides of the two triangles are equal and the three pairs of corresponding angles of the two triangles are equal. So, yes, of course, that is the sufficient condition. If three pairs of corresponding sides and corresponding angles of two triangles are equal, then closing our eyes, we will say that the two triangles will be congruent because in that case, they will have same size. Now, the point is, apart from that sufficient condition for congruence of two triangles, there are also other criterion or conditions which decide two triangles to be congruent. So what are they? What are the other criteria or conditions by which we can decide that two triangles are congruent? Today let us discuss. Children, there are four criteria. What are they? Four conditions. What are they? One is side condition, congruence condition. Side, angle, side, SAS, congruence condition. Then ASA, angle, side, angle, congruence condition. Then RHS, right angle, hypotenuse and side, congruence condition. Of course, there is another one known as your angle, side, AAS, but it is not there in the course of class 7. It will be taught in class 9. We shall discuss the concept of angle, side in class 9 only, not now. Okay. So, let us today discuss these four criteria or congruence conditions, namely SSS, SAS, ASA and RHS. So, what are these congruence conditions? Let us discuss in detail. Okay. So, first let us discuss what is SSS congruence condition. See, in order to understand what is SSS congruence condition, consider two triangles. Suppose ABC is one triangle, DF is another triangle. Okay. Suppose AB and D, they form one pair of corresponding, already I have discussed in detail. What are corresponding sides and what are corresponding angles? How to identify which sides are corresponding sides and which angles are corresponding angles? It has been discussed in detail in the last class. Okay. Suppose AB and D, they form one pair of corresponding sides. BC and EF, they form another pair of corresponding sides. AC and DF, these two form, say, the third pair of corresponding sides. See, children, in order that two triangles will be congruent, it is necessary to show that three matching parts of both the triangles must be equal. So, matching parts, what does matching parts mean? Matching parts mean your either corresponding sides or corresponding angles. Okay, I am discussing now what are matching parts. You see, now suppose you are given these two triangles ABC and DF. Suppose AB and D, they are corresponding sides, one pair. BC and EF, another pair corresponding sides. AC and DF, it is the third pair of corresponding sides. Suppose you are given that AB equal to 6 and D equal to 6 centimeters. See, that means this pair of corresponding sides, this one pair of corresponding sides, they are equal in length. Okay. Now BC and EF, it is another pair. Suppose they are 7 centimeters each. Then AC and DF, the third pair of corresponding sides of the two triangles, they are also equal given. Suppose 8 centimeters each. Now if this is the case or if this happens, what will happen? You see, that means mathematically, if AB equal to DE, BC equal to EF and AC equal to DF, then we say that the three pairs of corresponding sides of the two triangles are equal.
then we say that this triangle are congruent. See, mathematically I have written here, if AB equal to D, BC equal to EF and AC equal to DF, then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DF.
What condition is it? What is this condition called? It is called side congruence condition or congruence criterion. Children, I hope you understood. See, so what did we come to know from this discussion? From this discussion we came to know that if three pairs of corresponding sides of two triangles are equal, then also the two triangles are what? Congruent. It is not necessary that we will show the equality of corresponding angles. Okay? If only three pairs of corresponding sides of two triangles are equal, then also we can say that the two triangles are congruent. Okay, so this is about your side congruence condition or criterion. Now the next, side angle side. See, look at, in order to understand, see matching part. Yes, I was just discussing about the matching part. See, these three are matching parts. This is one matching part, AB and D. Matching part here, the corresponding sides. As I told you just few minutes ago, matching parts means corresponding sides of two triangles or corresponding angles of two triangles. So here the three matching parts are what? Only corresponding sides. Okay? Now, let us discuss what is side angle side congruence condition or criteria. In order to understand what is SS congruence condition, see children, let us take two triangles. Suppose ABC and PQR. Okay? Now what you do? Take this triangle and superpose it. Superpose means, suppose this triangle covers exactly triangle ABC. If triangle PQR exactly covers triangle ABC, what will happen? Clearly, vertex P and vertex A, they will coincide with one another. Vertex Q and vertex B, they will fall. Q will fall on B. Vertex Q will fall on vertex B. Okay? That means Q and B, vertex, the two vertices, they will coincide with one another. Similarly, R will fall on C. R and C will coincide with one another. Now, if B falls on A, vertex Q falls on B, vertex R falls on C, what will happen? Then clearly AB and PQ, it will form one pair of corresponding sides. BC and QR, it will form another pair of corresponding sides. AC and PR, it will form another pair of corresponding sides. Angle B and angle Q, it will be one pair of corresponding angles. Angle C and angle R, it will form another pair of corresponding angles. Angle A and angle P, it will also form another pair of corresponding angles. Okay, you came to identify which are corresponding sides and which are corresponding angles. Now what is SAS condition? See, so what does SAS condition say? SAS condition says, suppose AB, this is 5cm, and PQ, as I just told you now, AB and PQ, they form one pair of corresponding sides. Suppose the length of each side is 5 cm, that means they are equal. Now, suppose BC equal to 6cm and QR equal to, suppose, 6cm. See, here BC and QR, they form another pair of corresponding sides and the length is same, you see. Now, if AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR, now look at the angle. Look at the angle between these two sides. Between AB and BC, this is the included angle. What is included angle? Included angle means angle that comes between two sides. That is included angle. Look at angle B. It is coming between AB and BC. Here angle Q, it is coming between PQ and QR. So here B and Q, angle B and angle Q are included angles of the two triangles. Okay. Now suppose this is 30 degree. This is also 30 degree. So what we came to know? That means AB equal to PQ, angle B equal to angle Q, and BC equal to QR. BC equal to QR. Okay. So AB equal to PQ, angle B equal to angle Q, both are say 30 degree each. Then BC equal to QR. Suppose they are say 6 cm each. If this condition is satisfied, see, these are the three matching parts. So here, out of the three matching parts, this one part is corresponding side. This one is also one pair of corresponding side, but this is one pair of what angle? Corresponding angle. That means out of the three matching parts, two matching parts are corresponding sides, while the third matching part is a what? Corresponding angle. So if this condition is satisfied, that means if AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR, and angle B equal to angle Q, then also we say that triangle ABC and triangle PQR are what? Congruent. And this condition is known as your side angle side. Okay. Therefore, by SAS, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So what is SAS congruence condition, children? I hope you understood. So SAS congruence condition, what does it say? It says that if two sides of one triangle, see, I am giving the statement. If two sides of one triangle are respectively equal to two corresponding sides of another triangle and the included angle between them is same, then the two triangles are congruent. So this is known as your SAS. This is the mathematical form of SAS congruence condition. Now, SAS congruence condition, what is the statement? If three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to three corresponding sides of another triangle, then we say that the two triangles are what? Congruent. So this is your SAS congruence condition and this is your SAS, side angle side congruence condition. These are the two main conditions. So there are two other conditions also known as your ASA, angle side angle, and RHS, right angle, hypotenuse, side, okay, congruence condition. We shall discuss those two conditions in another class. Children, I hope you understood what is SAS congruence condition and what is SAS congruence condition. Children, the concept of congruence is very, very important. You must try to understand it. Otherwise, you cannot do geometry in higher class. It is true because the concept of congruence is applied in almost all sectors in geometry. In order to prove many different geometrical truths, the concept of congruence is used. You will come to know its use and applications later in when you will go to class 9. Children, I hope whatever I discussed you must have understood. If it is true, then please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.